Hello friends, I am Naveena, pursuing B.Tech in Svecw Engineering College for Women. Now I would like to discuss about Cathode Ray Oscilloscope, that is CRO. And the contents in the Cathode Ray Oscilloscope are: what is CRO, block diagram, CRT, working, applications, uses. Coming to what is CRO, the Cathode Ray Oscilloscope, which is mostly called as CRO, is an electronic device used for giving the visual indication of a signal waveform. In the early days, it is called as an oscillograph. CRO is widely used for troubleshooting radio and television receivers, as well as for laboratory research and design. The cathode ray oscilloscope was invented by German scientist Carl Ferdinand Braun in 1897 by applying an oscillating signal to electrically charged deflector plates in the phosphor-coated CRT. This is a visual representation of cathode ray oscilloscope. This is the block diagram of cathode ray oscilloscope. A CRO employs a cathode ray tube which acts as heart of an oscilloscope. The CRT generates the electron beam, which are accelerated to a high velocity and brought to focus on a fluorescent screen. This screen produces a visual spot where the electron beam strikes it. For this task, various electrical signals and voltages are needed, which are provided by the power supply circuit of the oscilloscope. Horizontal and vertical deflection plates are fitted between the electron gun and the screen, so these can deflect the beam according to the input signal. To deflect the electron beam on the screen on x-axis with constant rate, a time-based generator is provided. Low voltage supply is required for the heater of the electron gun to generate the electron beam, and high voltage is required for the cathode ray tube to accelerate the beam. Normal voltage supply is required for other control units of oscilloscope. The signal to be viewed is supplied to the vertical deflection plane through the vertical amplifier, so that it can amplify the signal to a level that will provide usable deflection of the electron beam. As the electron beam is deflected in x-axis and y-axis, a triggering circuit is provided for synchronizing these two types of deflection, starts at the same point of the input vertical signal each time it sweeps. This is the visual representation of cathode ray tube, which is the heart of the CRO. The cathode ray tube is a vacuum tube of specially geometrical shape which converts an electrical signal into a visual one. A CRT makes available a large number of electrons which are accelerated to high velocity and are brought to focus on a fluorescent screen, where it produces a spot when strikes it. The electron beam is deflected during its journey in response to the applied electrical signal. As a result, the electrical signal waveform is displayed visually. In every monitoring device, the entire front area of tube is scanned repeatedly and systematically in a fixed pattern called a raster. It has three electron beams: red, green, blue. So it produces color images, which are primary colors. This is the working of the CRO. Vertical deflection system. The main function of this amplifier is to amplify the weak signal so that the amplified signal can produce the desired signal. To examine the input signals are penetrated to the vertical deflection plates through the input attenuator and number of amplifier stages. Horizontal deflection system. The vertical and horizontal system consists of horizontal amplifiers to amplify the weak input signals, but it is different to the vertical deflection system. The horizontal deflection plates are penetrated by a sweep voltage that gives a time base. Intensity control. The intensity has a difference by changing the grid potential with respect to the cathode. There are mainly four types of sweeps. They are recurrent sweep, as the name itself says that the sawtooth is respective, that is, a new sweep is started immodestly at the end of the previous sweep. Triggered sweep. Sometimes the waveform should be observed, that is, may not be predicted. Thus, the design that the sweep circuit remains inoperative and the sweep should be initiated by the waveform under the examination. In these cases, we will use the triggered sweep. Driven sweep. In general, the driven sweep is used when the sweep is a free running, but it is a trigger by the signal under the test. Non-sawtooth sweep. This sweep is used to find the difference between the two voltages. By using the non-sawtooth sweep, we can compare the frequency of the input voltages. Synchronization. The synchronization is done to produce the stationary pattern. The synchronization is between the sweep and the signal should measure. There are some sources of synchronization which can be selected by the synchronization selector, which are discussed below. They are internal. In this, the signal is measured by the vertical amplifier and the trigger is obtained by the signal. External. In this, the external trigger should be present. Intensity modulation. This modulation is produced by inserting the signal between the ground and cathode. This modulation causes by brightening the display. Positioning control. By applying the small independent internal direct voltage source to the detecting plates through the potentiometer, the position can be controlled, and also we can control the position of the signal. Line. The line trigger is produced by the power supply. Coming to the applications of the CRO, there are various applications. Some of them are voltage measurement, current measurement, examination of waveform, measurement of phase and frequency. Coming to the uses of the CRO, in laboratory, the CRO can be used as it can display different types of waveforms. It can measure short time interval. In voltmeter, it can measure potential difference. Thank you.